places.
What he means is he's moving to some pig town that nobody's ever heard of.
Hey, people have heard of it.
Oh, yeah? What's the name of it?
You can find it on any map.
What's the name of it?
People are flocking to it from all over.
What's the name of it?
Beaumont.
Beaumont? Where the heck is Beaumont?
You're playing it so cool.
Look, I too wish your father hadn't left. I too wish things could be the way they were.
Okay.
And we both wish I could be one of those strong single mothers who suddenly become self-sufficient, but I'm not. Please, feel free to disagree.
Mom, we got a 10-hour drive. I think we'll have plenty of time to disagree.
We got to turn you around and push your feet on the ground.
I was reminded of a great line from our poet Walt Whitman, who once wrote, "I hear America singing." And I thought, aren't we the song that we sing? Don't we lift our voices to the world to tell them what we believe in and who we are? So I ask you, what song are you singing?
We've only been here 2 days and already Chicago seems a million miles away. But we were barely hanging on there, especially with my father gone. There's not too many places we could stay. Maybe Mom can find a job that's steady. Maybe I could stand it for a year. Maybe things won't be so bad. Maybe I won't miss my dad. And maybe we could start a new life here.
But if Walt Whitman were alive today, what song would he hear America singing? When I turn on the television, all I hear is the music of easy sexuality and relaxed morals. I hear the endless chant of pornography, and I think, why does our Lord allow this? We all know that he has the power to turn all these books and music and records into one big fiery cinder, like that. But he doesn't. And why is that? It's because he's testing us. He wants us to see if we'll choose his path. And that's why every day we must ask ourselves, have I done the right thing?
Have have I done the right thing? Picking up my life, packing up the past, that's always frightening. Have I done the right thing?
Our parish, two new souls just arrived from Chicago. Ethel McCormick and her son, Ron, is it?
Ron Weasley.
Ren.
What's that? Speak up! Let the Lord hear your voice!
Ren.
Ren.
Ren McCormick.
That's it? Is it short for something?
Nope.
This group is going round about the new kid. And everybody's talking till they're blue. Cause you know how the stranger is, and he's not always dangerous, but either way, at least it's something new.
And now, if you'll please join my wife, Vi, and I, as we sing in this morning's convocation.
God is love, follow him and never roam. He has made the stars.
Separated.
He went off to find himself.
Ren.
Bye. I made some high school house cookies. You taste one, you'll burn every recipe in your kitchen.
Won't you join us, Mrs. McCormick? Eleanor would like to show us what heaven tastes like.
Oh, please, call me Ethel.
Only if you'll call me Bye.
Send me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Ren, all set for school tomorrow?
Oh, we took care of that last week. Cook your healthy recipe.
Reverend, did you hear the new English teacher adding some vulgar modern novel into the English lit class?
Slaughterhouse-Five. Yes, I've received several calls about it.
Wait, Slaughterhouse-Five? Cool book, cover to cover. That's one jump-in story.
Yeah, Slaughterhouse-Five. Classic.
Do you read much?
Welcome to any other town's class.
In any other town, nonetheless.
Tom Sawyer is a classic.
Daddy, excuse me, but Rusty and the girls are going out for burgers tonight. Can I?
Tomorrow's a school night.
Aw, but Daddy.
Ask your mom.
Wait, see, we're more. We already did, and she said it was okay with her, but it was okay with you, so it was okay with you.
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. Great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you.
And you said about Walt Whitman and rock and roll and listening to the music in your soul. I mean, I was like, who knew?
High praise indeed. Gentlemen.
I, on the other hand, never thought my daddy was going to shut up.
Well then, Ariel, why don't you just talk to him?
Why? He never listens to me, and anyways, I... Hi, welcome to Beaumont.
Howdy.
You are cute, don't you think, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
I bet he knows he's cute, don't you think, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
Oh, where are you going, Kiwi?
Hey, girls, put your tongues back in your mouths and let's get out of here.
See ya.
And where are you going?
Where do you think?
Ooh.
And if the question comes up, I was with you guys all evening, right?
Are you asking us to lie for you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, you looking? Miss me?
You wish.
Hey there, Ariel.
Hi.
Hey, Travis. Hey, Lyle.
Oh my gosh, did I interrupt your guys' weekly poetry club?
Very funny. So, who's the new kid in church today?
Who? Oh, him. He's our new classmate. With all the charm and sophistication that comes from living in a bustling metropolis.
Should I be jealous?
I'm counting on it.
Hey, Chris. Just what do you think you're doing with the preacher's daughter?
Anything that I want.
What she get out of it?
Everything that she needs.
Like you know.
Well, she got you to think she was born yesterday with her wrist. Looks and her little town ways. When she's smiling at me, she's got angels in her eyes. But I've seen how she moves, and this girl really could. She's got me some tricks she can't learn in books. And I'm starting to think she's a devil in disguise. The girl gets around. She knows what she likes. I doubt what she needs.
Just wait.
We'll both make a move. Yeah, we'll come somehow. The girl gets around, 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 around. Good God, this girl gets around.
Ariel, I swear God's gonna crack you down with a lightning bolt.
No, he's not.
He's not? Excellent.
We were just on our way.
Your mom thought you'd be cold.
Evening, Reverend.
Thank you.
Hey, Ariel, right?
Yeah, so?
I'm Wren. Wren McCormick. I saw you at church yesterday. Is this a small world or what?
Howdy!
Girl, leave that poor boy alone.
Hey, mister, you bumped me.
I'm sorry.
Don't you ever look where you're going?
I said I was sorry.
Hey, you're that new kid from Chicago, ain't ya?
Perhaps.
Around here, you push someone, they push back. Pretty soon you got, two fellas pushing. Got it?
Got it. Let me ask you something. They sell men's clothing where you got that hat?
What is that, some kind of stupid joke?
No, that's a really good joke.
That's it! I'm gonna kill you!
Please! Kill me! Kill me! What? Kill me! Kill me! Kill me! That's the most exciting thing I've ever heard since I hit town. Wren McCormick.
Willard. Willard Hewitt.
So, Willard, what do you do around this town for fun? Got any clubs?
Nope.
What about malls?
Nope.
Do you have any movies?
Nope.
What about...
Nope, nope, and nope. We do have Bolarama down by the interstate, tractors.
You know what, I can never do what you guys do around here.
What is that?
Absolutely nothing!
Not nothing, hardly anything.
I didn't walk when I was run. Don't believe I ever could. People try to slow me down, saying, boy, you really should kick back and chill, but I can't stand still.
I can see that.
I told this doctor, he said, son, can I offer you a pill? So I never found relief, and now I've got to move until I've had my fill. I can't stand still.
I'm walk.
Back where I come from, life's never humdrum. I wish I could take there.
I'll pass.
Whoa, we got the world at our feet. Life is sweet, ain't no doubt. Grab a seat, man. Check it out. Oh, I thought it never would end, but I lost it somehow. Would you look at me now? I'm trying hard to tone it down. Gotta watch my P's and Q's. Maybe look before I leave. Then I say, hey, what's the use? Ain't done it yet. I can't forget how it feels when you cancel your job. So don't even think to suggest that I stop.
Stop!
I never will. I can. No, 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 no. No, 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 no,
no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no, no.
I can't stand. Chicago. No Chicago, that's all in town.
That's not what it looked like.
I was just showing him some steps, you know, stuff we used to do at the clubs.
Don't.
What, you mean this?
Miss McCormick, there's no dancing allowed in here.
Wait, what?
Listen to the woman.
You know the school grounds.
Wait. Oh, I get it. School grounds, not supposed to have any fun?
That's a remark made past for wits in Chicago, but here, we speak simply. There is absolutely no dancing allowed at any time, anywhere, within the town limits of Beaumont. Ever.
Is she serious? Come on, she's got to be kidding me, aren't
you? Mr. Hewitt, will you please inform your friend?
It's the law!
Dancing? Get out.
Grandma, where's the paper?
Mrs. Principal, ma'am, Rand was ignorant of our local law, and he's very sorry, and I will inform him of his ignorance.
And I'll see the both of you in my office after school.
Yes, ma'am.
Rand. I'm sure my office pays for me. Oh my gosh, Billy, the way you spoke to Principal Clark, that's like the longest sentence you've ever made.
Oh.
Ha 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 ha! Mr. McCormick. It's such a turn on watching a guy fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh.
Was she serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is illegal?
Has been for 5.5 years, ever since the accident.
What accident?
The Bhutani Bridge accident? You've never heard of the Bhutani Bridge accident.
If I had, would I have been doing this?
Well, ladies, should I take this one?
Please, be my guest.
Look, there were these 4 kids driving back from a big dance back in Baylor County. Maybe it was raining, maybe it was a little wild. Whatever it was, they skidded across a bridge and fell 35 feet into the Bhutani River.
Whoa, did anyone survive?
Gosh.
Yeah, and when the sheriff reported the autopsy report, they found marijuana and alcohol in their blood. Well, everyone in the town went nuts.
And that's when Reverend Moore got so righteous, blaming everything. Liquor, drugs, and rock and roll.
And dancing?
You got it.
He convinced the town council that it was all a sin, and just like that, he passed it as a law.
Wait, Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore!
He is the power.
He is the law.
How can you guys stand to live like this?
Practice. Here's practice.
You see, it's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know!
Yeah, I miss that. No, I always thought living in a small town was gonna be great. You know, like one big happy family.
Let me tell you about that family. There's tongues wagging every time you make a move.
There's fingers pointing every time you turn around.
There's head shaking the minute you cross the line.
And there's eyes. Careful what you do, someone's on to you. Careful what you do.
Careful what you say, cause you're on display every night and every day.
Somebody's hiding in the grate, unknown. Uh-huh. And every time you think that you're alone, somebody's eyes are watching.
Somebody's eyes are seeing you come and go. Somebody's out there waiting for the show.
You've got no disguise from somebody's eyes.
Thanks for the advice, but I think I'll be okay.
It's gonna get to you.
You don't know me.
You're no pro.
Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes. Whoa. Somebody, 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 somebody's eyes. Whoa.
Hey, you're gonna have to let that robot stop
trying to stop. I thought I did.
That radio music of yours is blasting pretty loud.
Oh, so you pulled me over because my music's too loud?
Hey, watch that attitude, boy.
Look, Jill. The city kid? I wanna let him kiss mine. Get out of here.
They seem nice.
Careful how you speak, turn the other cheek. Be careful how you speak.
Think a night, God, and if you get caught, well, boy, you are out of trouble.
Somewhere, someone with a perfect view. And you do. And they're just dying for a little peek-a-boo. Boo! Somebody's eyes are watching. Somebody's eyes will never close, never sleep. Somebody's after the secrets that you keep. He's got alibis from somebody's eyes.
Reverend Clark, this kid turned my wrestling practice into a brawl.
Yeah.
So I suppose my face just slammed into his fist?
Yes. Hey! My boys know the difference between wrestling practice and a street fight.
Oh, really? Usually wrestling matches one-on-one.
That's enough out of you. You're suspended from the wrestling team.
Somebody, 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 somebody dies. Whoa! Somebody, 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 somebody dies.
Do you know how hard it was for me to get you that job at Gilliam's Hardware Store? It's not even a month that you get fired.
Every day. Every day.
Lulu, don't exaggerate.
That's not how hot you're not helping things.
Ren, what did happen?
Nothing I should be fired for.
I was working and Willard asked for change for a dollar, so I opened up the register. When Mr. Dillingham saw my hand in there, he freaked out and accused me of stealing.
That's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you on drugs?
No, but why don't you first me? I'm pretty sure you already searched through everything in my room.
Apologize to your uncle.
Look, young man, I know I'm not your father.
You can say that again.
Wes!
Don't say anything, Ethel.
I cannot say anything, Wes. I don't know how to do that.
Pumpkin pie,
look, Wes, I realize we're guests in your home, but...
Ethel, right now just don't say anything.
Speak for myself.
Why don't you set the table?
I'm not really hungry anymore.
Shaw, if you're angry with Ariel, why didn't you tell her why?
I'm not angry. I'm just concerned.
Then say something. You two speak and nothing gets said.
Have you seen her with that Chuck Cranston? I mean... The last time I walked in on the two of them, they were...
You told me.
That boy has a record of arrests, Vi.
And the more you object, the more intrigued she's gonna be.
So I should just hold my peace?
I do. And I hope that her obsession with Chuck Cranston won't last any longer than mine with Elliot Criswell.
Elliot Criswell wasn't an overheated delinquent.
Oh, he most certainly was.
This isn't funny, Vi.
I'm just trying to lighten the mood.
Well, I can't. I'm concerned about where she's going and what she's doing.
Can't expect her to sit at home with us.
I don't know what to do. Let's just stop this conversation.
Conversation?
Bye.
I'm sorry. I seem to have walked in on one of your sermons.
Let's not say anything we'll regret.
Swallowing my words, I'm gazing at the floor, counting little cracks in the tile.
struggling to smile, thou choking, learning to be silent. Watching how the dust dances out the door, noticing my hands start to shake, contemplating taking up smoking, learning to be silent. Always hearing,
hush, Ethel.
Please, fine. Let's not have this conversation. And so I stand by while my mind takes a small vacation. La 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 la. Making little sounds other folks ignore, quieting the beat of my heart, never being part of the moment, learning to be silent, knowing there are some topics that we don't even mention,
and if they come up then we try to be vague.
There are topics from which we divert all attention.
Some we avoid like the plague.
I'm becoming alive,
biting my tongue,
biting my tongue,
trying not to scream.
My second day and I haven't been fired yet, so pretty good.
You may have found your future.
I may have. What would you ladies like to eat?
I'll just have a Diet Coke.
I'll have a Diet Coke. I'll have the Hula Double Patty Melt, extra mayo. Side order of fries, and for dessert, actually, I'll just have a Diet Coke.
And Ariel, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
Ooh.
Chuck sees you flirt with Ariel, you're a dead man.
She usually doesn't even remember me.
Well, that uniform makes you look like kind of a punk. Easier to pick out.
You are always looking for a fight, aren't you?
Mama says it's in my nature.
Willard, come on. So what's the deal with Ariel? Tell me about her.
Well, I know she can kiss a lot.
And?
And she's on to you like a hog to slop.
Get out of here.
If there's one thing Ariel lacks, it's trouble. And you've proved to the whole town that you are T-R-U-B-L trouble.
Come on, guys. I was only teasing him.
That was not just teasing. Ren is from out of town, and don't tell me that doesn't curl your toes.
You were out of Beaumont so bad, I bet you memorized bus games.
You said you read to escape to other worlds.
That's because in books, I get to read about guys who amaze me.
What about Ren?
What about him?
He's sort of smart.
He's got it all. I think he's handsome.
Cute? Maybe.
But can he really compete with Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout?
Slash drug dealer.
That was recently evicted from his trailer park? I don't think so.
So, what's the deal with you and Rusty?
I don't know. I mean, I think she's cute and all, but half the time I don't know what she's saying. She talks so fast and so much.
That's because you turn her off.
What? Really?
If only I could find a guy who made the first kiss. If only I could find a guy who wants to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth first.
If only I could find a guy.
Where have all the good men gone? Where's the streetwise Hercules to fight the rising eyes?
I'd like to know.
Isn't there a white knight upon a fiery steed? Late at night I toss and I turn.
no, we had a date half an hour ago.
No, you're right. I'm sorry.
I don't like you making a fool out of me.
And why would you? You do such a great job yourself.
Shut up, Rusty.
Will you be joining these ladies?
When I say meeting at 8, what am I, talking to myself?
No, you're right. Just calm down.
Calm down? Don't ever tell me to calm down. I know what your friends think of me, and that's bull. I'm the best part of this town, baby, and those three dogs ought to be tied up under a porch. Let's go.
No.
Keep the truck.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no. What part of that don't you understand?
Oh, when the preacher's daughter says no, it makes me so hot. Say it again, baby.
No, Chuck, stop. Don't.
I believe the lady said no.
And I believe this is none of your business.
Ren, don't.
Ariel, who invited this clown?
Oh, I don't think we've been formally introduced. Ren McCormick.
Get your hair out of my face and get your face out of my sight.
Chuck, you want to fight? Let's party.
Let's go.
Come on.
Hey,
let's go.
Hey. We got a problem here?
No, we were just discussing the pleasure and safety of one of your valued customers.
You think that's funny?
Yeah.
Your truck is in a handicapped parking. That's a spot reserved for people with physical, not emotional, disabilities.
You haven't seen the last unicorn.
I mean, kick his ass! I'll nail him!
What's that your mama says? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your fight.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, don't the rest of you have a curfew? Ren.
Yeah, I'll turn on my skates.
I'll see you after school here tomorrow.
Really? I'm not fired?
Not yet. Now, give me a push.
You are either very brave or very stupid.
Which do you think?
I don't know. I haven't made up my mind yet. You want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
Oh, you're right. Please, my daddy invented the curfew. Come on!
No thanks, I just ate. You know, you really are something.
What do you mean?
I mean, you're the whole package. Preacher's daughter, Chuck Cranston's girlfriend.
Guilty.
Just a church-going gal with some badass vocabularies.
My daddy hates me wearing these red boots.
And you love that, getting up in his face?
That way he'll notice when I'm gone.
Wait, where are you gonna go?
College, for starters. I've applied to some places my daddy doesn't even know about. I want to speak 5 languages and see the world. He wants me to teach English in Baylor County. They don't even speak English in Baylor County.
You know, I can't imagine you as a teacher.
Thank you. Neither can I. I'll leave that to my daddy.
Wait, he's a preacher, not a teacher.
When you're good at it, it's the same thing. And he used to be real good.
What changed?
His mind. He closed it.
I can see that.
I've seen him change so many lives. He used to be so inspiring, giving hope to people when all hope was gone.
If you love him so much, why do you always want to take him off?
I didn't say I love him.
Boy, do I know what you mean. My dad.
Yeah? What happened there?
No, I couldn't.
Tell it to the train. I do.
Oh, how could you be so stupid to leave Mom and me? I hate you!
Feel better?
I don't know.
Do you want to kiss me?
someday.
Someday? What do you mean someday?
Well, I have a feeling you've been kissed a lot, and I'm afraid I'd suffer by comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you?
Oh, I think more of you than I thought I did. Come on, I'll walk you home.
My prayers seem to fail me is at the bridge table.
Come on, just say hello to everyone.
I don't think that's...
Hi, everyone. Daddy, meet Ren.
Hey, Reverend Moore. Coach Dunbar, Principal Clark.
I'm Mrs. Dunbar.
Mrs. Moore.
Welcome, Ren.
Whoa, poker night. Cool.
Ariel, we thought you were upstairs in your room.
Doing your homework?
It's hard to impose a curfew on children of this community when I can't seem to enforce one in my own home.
Well, you know, there's that old expression, the shoemaker's children always go barefoot.
Oh, would you look at the time? You should be going.
Boy, do I know how to empty your room.
It's a rare talent.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Oh, I can assure you, it was not meant that way.
I believe this is yours.
Ren, thanks for, you know...
Walking you home?
Yeah, that too.
That was fun, don't you think, Reverend? Boy, I blew it.
Yeah, you did.
I just get so nervous and then I go crazy and I end up putting my foot in my mouth.
Well, your mother told me you were good at it, but I had no idea.
Well, good night, Miss.
Good night.
I don't want you to see him again.
Ren? Why? Just because he hasn't lived in this town his whole entire life?
No, but clearly the boy has no respect for authority, and everybody tells me he's a troublemaker.
Who's everybody? The Bridge Club? Give me a break!
Ariel, what am I gonna do with you?
Me, Daddy, Lily, all you do is look for the worst in people, and then, of course, you find it!
My, where did this come from?
From you, Daddy. Today's sermon is, the world is evil and Ariel has to be locked up forever.
That's a little melodramatic, don't you think?
No, I don't, Daddy. You made me feel like a prisoner, and I hate it. I just hate it.
Someone's got to put their foot down.
I didn't say anything.
Don't enjoy being her jailer. Don't relish telling her no. Then I think, what if I fail her? How can I just let her go? I strive to be a good preacher. I try not to go overboard. Then I think, if I can't reach her, how can I face my Lord? Heaven help me find my way now. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbor? If I don't, who will? I became a man of God to do his work, to spread his word, to ease some pain and dry some tears. That was the plan. But I might have thought twice. Only I knew that I'd spend all of my time saying, no, don't do that. See, everybody prays for salvation, and I'm happy to give them the tools. And the problem is, here's my frustration, nobody wants to have rules. So
help me with my labors. How can you expect one man to save his family and his neighbors? Heaven help me. Oh, heaven help me. If heaven can't, who can?
Ah, Mr. McCormack, you and your friends are late.
Coach, Ren is hurt. Look at his eye.
His arm, it's all banged up.
It's nothing.
Oh, please, don't waste your breath or my time with another one of your lame excuses.
But it's not an excuse. After Ren walked home last night, some guys jumped him.
There was like six of them, and they all just started wailing on him.
There was three of them.
Anyone you know?
I wasn't taking names, if that's what you're asking.
It seems like whenever you're trying to get away from trouble, it finds you. And Ariel, I would highly advise you stay away from this person. I was told to keep my eye on you.
Oh, my daddy called you. Surprise, surprise.
And if you cooperate, it'll make all our lives much easier.
Gee, if my daddy made a phone call, would you get off my back?
That loud mouth of yours is probably why your daddy left you in the first place.
Count to ten. Mama's count to ten.
You'd be wise to listen to your friend. Ariel, get back to practice. And you, Mr. McCormack, get down and give me 30.
Are you serious?
You know what? You're right. Make it 50!
Coach, he's not joking. His arm's really hurt.
Thank you for your diagnosis, Dr. Willard. You can give me 50 as well. You know what? You all can give me 50! And you can thank Mr. McCormack for that one.
Let's do it! Come on! Newport, get down! And one! Two! I can't hear you!
Four!
Four! Get down with him! Holy Christ, it's one!
Thank you, coach!
Six! Hello,
coach. Is he gone?
Thanks a lot, Ren.
I'm sorry, guys, but this whole damn town is so wound up.
Amen.
You guys have nowhere to let off any steam.
Got that right.
Even in Chicago, we have the clubs.
Hey, maybe we ought to take the coach dancing.
Willard, you are so...
What? So what?
That's it.
Uh-oh, what are you thinking?
We'll throw a dance. We'll throw a kick-ass party that'll throw Beaumont right off of this track.
You just asked for a
fight. Bring it on.
Are you ready to take on that?
I'll fight anybody.
What about the town council?
I'll fight the council. If there's anything worth fighting for, it's freedom.
Looking into your eyes, I know I'm right. Where you, I guarantee, to hold our ground.
wish to change the law and throw a dance. Let us remind ourselves that this law is not about dancing. This is a tribute to the four souls that were lost that night.
Heaven helps the men.
Stand united in their memory.
We can face it down.
It's called the Barbecue. We call it the finest little dance palace in the county. Let's go.
Then what are we waiting for?
Oh God. This. A bit.
Now come on, let's dance!
I think I'll have a beer first.
Ugh, wait, who's gonna drive?
I'll drive.
This sounds good. Then I'll have a beer too. Okay.
Willard, I want to dance! I want to dance!
Two beers. I only got two hands. Grant, shut me out here.
Excuse me.
Let me guess. Willard's acting weird.
So it's not just me?
Rusty, you and Willard have been weird since kindergarten.
But this is our first time outside of Beaumont. Maybe we don't travel well.
Rusty, it's just a car ride.
But it's not just a car ride. You see, this is our first date. Oh, I should have seen the signs. All the way up here, I had to do all the talking. And all he had to say was, Can't you see, Ariel? My baby's in a panic.
You're making yourself crazy. Come on, I'll dance with you.
You okay? You seem jumpy.
That's why I'm having a beer. Mama says I can have one beer or one cigarette, but if I ever have birth, never to return home.
Okay, Willard, come on. You finally go on a date with Rusty.
Hold on, Mom. This is the date? You asked me to go driving with you, and Ariel brought Rusty. If anything, it's like I'm on a date with you.
And you look so handsome tonight.
Thank you. But point is, you took me in the backseat with that crazy woman, just kept moving and talking. And
that's because she's excited to be with you.
Well, yeah, but see, the problem is...
Yes?
Between you and me...
Huh? What is it?
I can't do it.
You can't do it? Oh, you can't do it. Well, that's okay. You don't have to do it on the first date.
Right.
Like, even in Chicago, people don't do it on the first date.
Really?
I swear.
Oh, that makes me feel a lot better.
Great, then let's go dance.
Dance, dance! What the heck did you think I was talking about?
Well, when you said you couldn't do it, I thought you meant...
What? Oh, it. Shoot, any idiot can do it. I can't do this. I can't dance!
What?
Come on, guys, give him a break.
That ain't natural.
It's like riding a bike, falling off the log.
It's as easy as learning to swim.
I can't swim either.
Hey, fellas, what do you say you push me in the pool?
My baby, not me.
Oh, Miss Moore.
Did I scare you?
Nope. Not at all. Did you tell Ariel that I...
I've told her every time you've called.
Thanks. She must be busy and all.
She and the girls went to Wendy Jo's to study.
Really? Because I was just there and nobody was home.
Oh.
Why, who is it? Mr. Cranston.
Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
Isn't it a little late, Mr. Cranston?
Yes, sir. That's why I'm surprised she's not home.
So am I. Good night, Mr. Cranston. And remember, next time, we have a front door for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Jo's. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
And you knew about this?
I did not.
Well, how's it feel, Vi? Now that she's lying to you.
I'm not saying anything until I get an explanation from her.
How long are you going to keep defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
Rusty and Wendy Jo and
Stop it. No. Don't even bother.
We know you weren't at Wendy Jo's.
I can't believe you guys are checking up on me.
Sweetie, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
We're concerned for your well-being.
Then how come when I'm at home, you're never interested in how I'm feeling, but the second I walk out the door, you guys are suddenly the concerned parent?
Shaw, she doesn't mean that.
Stop it. Stop taking her side. You need to start answering for yourself.
I don't know what good that would do. You never listen to her.
Shaw! I know.
We're losing her, Vi. She's becoming willful and obstinate.
Like her father.
I'm her spiritual guardian.
You used to be her friend.
I don't know what to do. I'm...
Yes, you do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey? Well, part of her is dying to run away. Can you hear what she's trying to say? You have to repent, or are there ways to make her understand without using the back of your hand? Can't you remember when we were that age, pumped up with promise and wrestling with rage? Can't you remember when we were possible demands on Ariel.
No, I have not confused Ariel's behavior with the death of my son.
He was my son too. Shaw, it's been 21 years I've been a minister's wife, and I still believe you're a wonderful preacher. You can lift a congregation so high, they have to look down to see heaven. It's the one where you need a little work.
I thought you at least believed.
Does it ever cross your mind that I miss you? Is there any chance we'll find the joy that we shared at the start? Can't you remember what you felt before that feeling fell apart? Can you find it?
is me. Can you stop? Alright, hold on.
Brent, you're gonna be talking to Reverend Moore and all the town council members. So all you say it is, don't mumble. Now do that last part again one more time.
Members of the council, dancing is not a crime.
Yeah!
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 Yeah, ever since the dawn of time, if anything, everybody had the right to howl at the moon and to move all night.
Woo!
Move all night!
When folks were tribal, back before the Bible, they were liable to dance when the crops came in. Or they pulled all the stops when the earth would spin. Or maybe,
what?
They had a battle to win, so they would dance. Anytime they had the chance, whatever the season or circumstance, they got a reason to throw a party in their pants. So they would dance.
You said party in your pants.
Oh, hell yeah. All right, hold up.
Grant, we're not saying it's bad. We're just saying it's no good.
What am I supposed to say then? I've already rewritten it 9 times.
We're going to be talking to the Reverend and the most stubbornest people in town.
You've already got plenty of people boiling mad.
Yeah, folks are picking sides, and they're not picking yours.
And who am I kidding? This has all gotten way out of hand. Maybe I should just give up.
Hold on, little buddy. We don't mean to discourage you.
After all the posters we painted
and flyers we passed out, people are climbing the walls.
All we're saying is maybe you need to rethink your approach. Now, my mama always said,
my mama again.
Shut up.
Here's what she thinks.
This is what mama says. Every time I turned around, I turned to mama first. Well, at my mama's knee. Everything I ever learned gets me through the worst. Ain't you wise to memorize what mama says to me? Now mama ain't been wrong yet, and I'm living proof.
Ain't that kind of a funny thought?
Mama says don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now who can argue with that? Mama says don't hold your breath longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at, and mama says it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown. Once you drive up a mountain, you can't back down.
You can't back down, man.
Now ready to end the trip. My mama, these boys have them younger fellas.
Mama says,
don't laugh around. She never taught me to talk.
Mama says,
never read anything that's bigger than your head. Is she a whiz or what?
Oh yes.
And Mama says,
she says,
matter if you're a king.
Mama says,
one.
Why doesn't your mom just talk to you?
They think she's crazy.
Mama says,
what you believe is on your throne.
Ooh,
I believe that she's right.
Mama says,
if you got doubts, boy, no, you're not alone. This means you're ready to fight.
Thank you.
Mama says, don't buy a chandelier unless you've got a ceiling. I don't really know what that's about. Mama says, don't chew on tinfoil unless you lack a feeling. Somehow she figured it out. And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you're a kid or a clown. Once you drive up a mountain, remember, boy, everyone's counting on you. Once you drive up the mountain, you can't back down. That's my mama.
Boys, let's get
him. Will it stop? I'm in enough trouble tonight, and I don't want to get into any more.
Chuck's been on a little tear since our field trip to the barbecue dance palace.
I'm just so mad at myself. I don't know why I was with him in the first place.
Let me look at your eye. Maybe we should call a doctor.
No, I'm fine.
Do you want me to call your folks?
No, please. I just want to be alone, okay?
Now, come on, guys. Let's go.
Do you want some company?
No, it's okay. Maybe.
Are you sure? I won't take it personally if you...
Shh. Come on, you'll miss it. One of the four kids who held the promise of Beaumont's brightest future.
Why didn't I know about this?
Ever since Daddy realized the town he needed saving, he never mentioned Bobby ever again.
I bet you miss him a lot.
I try not to think about it.
And that never works. How do you think about him all the time?
How did you know that?
I study.
Yeah? What do you see?
Somebody who's smart.
Thank you.
Maybe a little bit angry.
Maybe a lot.
And somebody was sad. I always wondered where that came from.
Now you know.
What?
It's just that nobody's ever really looked at me like you have.
Oh, I think about you 24 hours a day.
That dreams belong to other men. Each time I go close, they fall apart again.
I swear my heart would beat in secrecy. I face the nights alone. How could I have known that all my life I only needed you? Heaven's door, almost paradise. Listen.
The Holy Bible?
Yep, I marked all the pages.
Whoa! Where did you know where to find all of this stuff?
Red.
Oh. Thanks.
I thought that perfect love was hard to find. I'd almost given up. You must have read my mind.
And all those dreams I saved for rainy day,
they're finally coming true. I share them all with you, 'cause now we hold the future in our hands. Oh, almost paradise. We're knocking on heaven.
Class at Roma High School. I would like to move that ordinance 416, the law against dancing within the town limits of Beaumont, be abolished.
And I, Willard Hewitt of 385 Cloverdale Road, would like to second the motion. Thank you.
May I have the floor, please?
Certainly, Reverend.
Bren, you wish to change the law because you want to throw a dance, and that's your right. But it is my duty to challenge any enterprise in which my experience abuses the use of alcohol, drugs, and most importantly, celebrates spiritual corruption. Now, I think that you're going to find and that in this community, most people agree with me.
Got that right!
Stand down! Now, if anyone can convince me otherwise, there is no danger in your raucous party plans, I might reconsider. But for now, I cannot condone it.
I believe that a vote is in favor. Well, all of them.
Wait,
favor.
Don't we get to discuss this?
No, discussion's closed.
It's outrageous. Why would you even
Roger! Roger, sit down. I believe Mr. McCormick has the right to be heard.
First, I want to say, I think this idea scares a lot of people, and it shouldn't. From the oldest of times, people dance for many different reasons. They dance so that their crops would be plentiful, and they dance so that their hump would be good, and they dance to show their community spirit. But most importantly, they dance to celebrate. And that's the kind of dancing we're talking about.
Ren, we don't need a history lesson.
And doesn't it say in Psalm 149, excuse me, Reverend, doesn't it say to praise the Lord? Sing to the Lord a new song. Let them praise his name with dancing. And it's King David. King David and Samuel. And what does David do? What did David do? What did David do? David danced before the Lord with all of his might, leaping and dancing before the Lord. Leaping and dancing. And it's Ecclesiastes 3 that assures us that there is a time and place under heaven for anything. There is a time for mourning, and there is a time for weeping. There is a time to laugh, and there is a time to dance. There is a time for this law, but not any longer. This is our time. Our time to celebrate life. This is how it was in the beginning, it's how it's always been, and it's how it should be now. Thank you.
About keeping my opinion to myself. But honey, if I don't say something, I'm gonna bust.
There's nothing to say. I lost. The council voted and I lost.
Sweetie, you never had a prayer.
It's not funny, Mom.
Look, when you got to that part about leaping and laughing and weeping and dancing, which I loved, don't get me wrong, I was watching the faces of the town council members. And I promise you, Shaw Moore had those votes locked up before he even walked in here tonight.
Wait, you think he told him how to vote?
You can still sound shocked. I love that about you.
But isn't he a man of God?
He's a man. And you were railroaded.
Damn, that pisses me off.
Good. Now listen, Reverend Moore said he would reconsider only if you convinced him there was no danger in your raucous party plans.
Raucous party man? Party plans? Like, can you believe these people? What?
Make him reconsider.
Me.
You.
And him?
Yep.
When?
Now.
But,
Ren.
Mom.
Stop! Until you do, you'll never make peace with that man or this town.
But he wasn't listening here.
Make him listen.
I said everything I had to say. I read my speech. I even done my Bible.
You did everything but speak from your heart.
Reverend Moore is a smart man.
So are you.
He's stubborn.
And you're not? Look, I'd love to stay and watch, but I've got to go hose down your aunt and uncle.
I love you, Mom.
You have no choice. Now go!
One question. Reverend, at the town meeting tonight, did you tell the council how to vote?
We discussed the issue.
But did you tell them how to vote? Ren, this is more of a question about the dance.
Did you? Reverend, I understand what this town is going through.
No, I don't think you do. Because if you did, you wouldn't have reopened wounds that we had already
healed. Those wounds are not healed. If they were, people wouldn't be glaring at me on the streets. And they wouldn't be snubbing my mom at the market. They wouldn't be boycotting my uncle's business, and you definitely wouldn't be fixing the vote in the town.
I thought it was time to put an end to this nonsense.
Nonsense? All I say is, who's up for a little dancing? And all people can think about is the Petone Bridge and the four kids that died. And I know your son was one of them, and I'm sorry,
Mr.
I truly
McCoy.
Am. But honoring their memory by shutting out the world is not working.
Oh, and I assume you have all the answers, right?
No, I didn't.
Then you're gonna set me straight.
I didn't say that.
You don't know what I've been through. You don't have a clue. Good night, Mr. McCormick.
Please.
I want to be left alone.
No, sir, you already are. We both are. You and me, we both lost somebody. And even though people say they understand, they don't. I bet you stop 100 times a day and wonder why. I do. I wonder, why my dad leave? Was it something I did? Was it something I didn't do? Could I have made him stay? Maybe I could bring him back. But I can't. But I don't have to tell you how that feels. You already know.
I do.
So I guess I came to town frustrated and angry. And it felt really good to kick up a fuss. And I'm sorry that got people upset. But I'm so tired of looking back. And I can't stand still. Look, I'm gonna go now. I know you're gonna do what you gotta do about the dance and all, but thanks for listening.
Ren. I'm sorry that your dad never got to meet you.
Thanks.
Daddy?
I didn't hear you come down.
I heard voices.
That was your friend, Ren. He sure asked a lot of questions.
What did you tell him?
For once, I had very little to say. I think I'm running out of answers.
Daddy, I know this is hard for you, and I know I don't make it any easier. It's just that I don't know if I believe in all the same things that you do, but I do believe in you. You should get some sleep. You have a sermon in the morning.
If I can figure out what I'm gonna say.
You will.
Souls come to me for protection. I guide them whatever the cost. But maybe it's me who got lost.
Help me find my way now. Open up my heart again. Tell me all the words to say now. Heaven, help me. Oh, heaven, help me.
Good morning, everyone. I stand before you with a very troubled heart. You see, as your minister, I should be helping you all find the joy in your life. And last night I realized that I haven't been doing that. You see, we all remember that terrible night 5 years ago on the Petone Bridge. Everyone in this community lost someone. A neighbor, a friend, a child. Vi and I, we lost our son. Ariel lost her brother. And somehow, I got it in my head that my loss was the greatest, that my pain was the deepest. And then someone much younger than me made me realize that I was holding on too tightly to that memory. A memory that weighed me down as surely as a great stone. And then I did something I haven't done in a very long time. I laid my burden down, and it was a terrifying moment, but it was exhilarating. And this morning, I want to offer you that same opportunity. So to the senior high class of Beaumont, I think that dance is a great idea. Now please, join me as we pray to the Lord to
thank you, Lord! Thank you, sir!
Yeah. Go in peace!
Yeah. bucks, 12 bucks.
And on my 23rd try, I finally tell my lie.
I've got this feeling that time's no longer holding me down.